Good morning, children. Today we are going to see in the time chapter quarter past and quarter two. Children, in the last class we have just seen the long hand and the short hand, the hour hand and the minute hand, and also the half past. So I'd explain you when it is half past, when the minute hand comes on the six and when the short hand is on some number there. So half past, for example, if the short hand is on 11 and the long hand is on 6, so it is half past 11. The time is 11:30. So that was about the half past. Now what is this quarter past and quarter two, children? So I told you in the last class also, quarter is nothing but 15 minutes. Quarter is nothing but a 15 minutes. Now when we say quarter past is what? See here, when, for example, I can show you here, you can see in the first clock, quarter past 10. So what is quarter past? 10 o'clock is over and 50 minutes they have finished. So it is, the time is 10:15. So quarter past 10 o'clock and 15 minutes is over. So it is quarter past, we say. After 10 o'clock, 15 minutes is over. So that is quarter past. Quarter 2. What is quarter 2? 15 minutes is left there. 15 minutes is left for how much here? For 10 o'clock. So what is the time in the next clock? You can say it is 9:45. So 15 minutes to 10 o'clock. So we say quarter 2. Understood? Quarter past and quarter 2. See the difference there. 15 minutes is over for 10 o'clock here. And 15 minutes is there for 10 o'clock to get over there. Understood? See, in the first clock, minute hand is at 3 and hour hand is little after 10. See here, little after 10. So you can see the hour hand, the short hand, and here the long hand. The minute hand is on the 3. So we say it is quarter past 10. So what we say here? Quarter past 10. So written as 10:15. So what it is, 10 o'clock is over and 15 minutes is past. So it is quarter past 10. And in the same next clock here, minute hand is at 9. You can see the minute hand, the long hand. And the hour hand is little before 10. So it is between 10 and 11. So it is quarter to 10. So 15 minutes is left for 10 o'clock. So what we say here, quarter to 10. Understood? So like that, let us see the next here. Write the time shown by the clock first in the short form, then in the words to have been done. See here, write the time here. They have shown you the A and B here. In the first clock, you can see the time there. In the first clock, you can see the time there. It is 6:15. So quarter past 6. 6 o'clock and 15 minutes is over. So it is 6:15. Understood? You can see the hour hand is on the 6 and the long hand, that is minute hand, is on the 3. So quarter past 6. In the B1, the time is 3:45. So what is 3:45 here, children? Quarter to 4. So the hour hand is between 3 and 4. It is almost coming near the 4. And the minute hand is on the 9. So 15 minutes is left for 4 o'clock. So what we say here? Quarter to 4 o'clock. So this is 3:45. What we write here? This is short form. This is 3:45. That is the short form. And quarter to 4. That is in words. Understood? Now, can you see the next time here? Can you see the next time here? You can see here. What is the time here? Yes, children. What is the time here? Can you see there? The hour hand is on the 1 and the long hand, the minute hand, is on the 3. So what is the time here? It is 1:15. What is the time here? You can write here it is 1:15. So what you say here? Quarter past 1. What you say here? Quarter past 1. So 1 o'clock is over and 15 minutes is past. So what you say here it is 1:15. The next figure, can you see here? So you can see the hour hand is between 7 and 8, and the long hand, the minute hand, is on the 9 here. So the time is here 7:45. Yes or no, children? It is not on the 8 there. It is between 7 and 8. So the time is here 7:45. Correct? So it is 7:45. For 8 o'clock, it is 15 minutes. So what we write here? 7:45. Correct? Is it correct, children? So 1:15 and 7:45. Understood? Now see the next one there. Can you see the next figure there? Draw the hands of the clock to show the time given. You can see here, draw the hands. They have given you 5:15, 6:45, 11:15, 1:45. So you have to draw the minute hand and you have to draw the hour hand. Our hand should be always short, minute hand should be always big. Now first one they have given you here 5:15. So do you know how to draw now? 5:15. Where should be the hour hand and where should be the minute hand? Yes, children. The hour hand should be on the 5 there and the minute hand should be on the 3 there. So you can show the time as 5:15. So please do the homework here, B, C and D. Even A also you can draw. I'm not done here. Even you can show the time here, the short hand on the 5 and the long hand on the 3 here. So please do this. Draw the hands of the clock and show the given time in that. Understood? Now see the next page there, children. Can you see the next page here? Yes. Next question here. Write the time shown by the clock in short form and in words. So write the time. Write the time in the short form. I told you what is a short form. And also in the words here. Now you can see the first clock. Yes, children. What is the time? Who's going to say me here? The short hand is on the 4 and the long hand is on the 3. So what is the time here? 4:15. So what we write here? 4:15. 4:15. What we write here? 4:15. So 4 o'clock is over and 15 minutes over. So it is 4:15. Correct, children? Now the next time there. Who's going to say here? See here. The hour hand is between 1 and 2. And the minute hand is on the 9 there. So what is the time here? 1:45. Correct? So it is between 1 and 2. So what is the time here? 1:45. So what is the time here? We can write 2:15. 2:15. So for 2 o'clock, 15 minutes is left. So what we are going to say here? 2:15. Understood? C and D is homework. See the time and do the homework there. C and D is homework. Understood? Draw the hands. Next one there. Draw the hands of the clock to show the time given. See here, they have given you again the, you have to draw the hands. 5:45, 7:15, 4:45, 10:45, 9:15 and 2:15. So please draw the hands. Again, I'm saying the hour hand should be small and the minute hand should be long there. So please draw the here hands for the clock. Show the 1:15 or it is 2:15. Understood? In few, they have given you here the time 5:45. So it is 6:15. Understood? So you have to draw the hands also and please write the time in words also. You can write the time in words also down here. Understood? So please write the time in words also, draw the hands also. Okay children, see the next page here, page number 116. Page number 116. Now calendar day and date. So what is this calendar date and day? You know the calendar, na? You know how many months are there in a year? So there are 12 months. And every day you see the day and every day you see the date also. Now for example, today is Wednesday. So what is the date today? Today is 15th. So like that, every day you see which date is there today, which day is today, which month is today, like that. Now here they have given you small activity. This is homework for you people only, children. Page number 106, everything is homework for you. See here, let us see here. Look at this year calendar. So this is which year, you know? This is the 2020 year. We are all facing the COVID-19 here, right? The pandemic year. This is 2020 year. Write the date and the day on which these will fall. So you have to see the day. Now here, Parsi New Year. So you people have studied in your SST. What is Parsi New Year? So in which day, in which date, in which month it comes? So what they have asked you here, write the date and the day on which these will fall. So you have to write the day also and the date also. Independence Day, on which date it is and on which day it has come. For example, Independence Day came on Monday. So you have to write here Monday and write the date. You know what is Independence Day, na? 15th of August. Gudi Padwa. So you know Gudi Padwa, it's a new year for the people who celebrate this harvest festivals. It's a new year for Gudi Padwa, for the Maharashtrian, for the Karnataka people and all those. It's a Gudi Padwa, they say it's a new year. So find out when was Gudi Padwa in 2020. Christmas. Now coming festival is Christmas. So you know which date the Christmas come. That is on 25th December. So when is 25th December? Is it Friday, Saturday, Sunday? You have to write the date here. Republic Day. So when is Republic Day? Republic Day was on 26th January. So which day that 26th January has come? You have to write it. Diwali. Just now we have finished the big festival of Hindu people, Diwali. So it was on November 18th, 19th, I suppose. So write the date and the day. Eid al-Fitr. So when was Eid festival? Even Eid festival also just now went. So when was Eid al-Fitr was celebrated? So you have to write the date and the day. So everything you can find in the calendar, children. Look at the calendar, find out the date and the day there. Baisakhi. So it's a festival for the Punjabi people, you know. Baisakhi, that is also a harvesting festival. How we celebrate Sankranti here, people in Punjab celebrate Baisakhi. You people have learned in SST. So write down the date when it is celebrated and the day. Okay, everything, this is whole book is homework for you people. Everything is homework. Now see here, look at this year calendar, name the following. Again, you have to see the calendar and you have to write here. They have asked you a few questions. Festival in the month of March. So, which are the festivals in the March? You have got it. You have to write it. Public holidays in the month of October. What are the public holidays? For example, Gandhi Jayanti. So, 2nd October. So, that's a public holiday. So, that's in here you have to write. Name the following. Look at the year calendar and name the date here. So, which are the holidays here? So one is Gandhi Jayanti. So which is another holiday you got in the month of October? You have to write there. Dates of Sundays in February. So which are the dates in the month of February which has come on only Sundays? That you have to write. Number of Saturdays in the month of June. So there are 4 Saturdays or there are 5 Saturdays in the month of June. You have to write here. The day and the date your family will celebrate your new year. So when do you celebrate new year? For example, if you are a Maharashtrian, I told you for a Maharashtrian, the Gudi Padwa is a new year. For if you are a Karnatak people, even for Karnatak people, they celebrate Gudi Padwa, that's a new year. And for us, if we celebrate New Year, we say New Year is on the 1st of January. That we say, right? After 31st, the New Year comes, the New Year we say. Understood? So for our family, which we celebrate, you have to write here. Number of days in February. So in 2020, if it is a leap year, is it a leap year? If it's a leap year, in February we have how many days? So find out and write here. Understood? Whether we have February 28 days or 29 days. You know now what is leap year? Every fourth year we get the leap year there. Understood? So all this thing you have to have the calendar and you have to find out and write there. Next question. Question number 3 there. Find the age of the members of your family and complete this table. Write the day they will celebrate or celebrated their birthday in the current year. See here, who are the members of your family? If you have brother, sister, father, mother, grandmother, grandfather, if you are very big family, or if you have any small family, you can write your brother, sister, father and mother. So when is the date of the birth? For example, if you write my name, okay, my name is Shruti, I write here, your family member name, okay. Then you can write the date of the birth. When is your date of birth? If it is on 15th of January, the day the birthday will fall on. So which day the birthday will come? If it is 15th January, which day it is, whether it is Sunday, whether it is Monday, whether it is Tuesday. So you have to write the day here. Understood? So do this is an homework also. So all these things we need calendar. So calendar plays very important role here to find out the day, date, which festivals comes when, which when we celebrated our birthday and all those things. Understood? So next one here. Yes. Sequence. So what is the sequence, children? In a simple language, one by one, we stand. See, stand according to height, you they say in your class, or when you do the prayer, stand according to your height wise. So we are making a sequence here. The smaller come first, then the next little taller, then the next little taller. So that is a sequence here. Understood? Now for example, if I want to prepare a cake, if I want to prepare a cake, so what are the materials I need? I need milk, I need cocoa powder, I need egg, I need the flour and everything. So which sequence comes first? For example, now if I make a cake, first I want a flour, then I want a milk powder, then I want a cocoa powder, everything. So we are arranging it in a sequence. We are arranging it in a one by one pattern, that is. Understood? So what is the sequence here? Let us read what is the sequence here. Sequence is a particular order in which related things follow each other. So it's, I told you, it's a sequence is nothing but a, in an order it follows. Some of the words that describe the sequence are first, last, soon, next, afterwards, finally and later. So these are the words which we come in the sequences. For example, first I want a, if I want, I told to prepare a cake, first I want a flour, the next I want a cocoa powder, then as soon as I want next the chocolate powder. So all these words we use in a sequence. Understood? Sequence is nothing but in a particular order the things follow in. Now see children, arrange these sentences to show the sequence of events. Circle the words that describe the sequence. So which are the words? Like they have given you here, first, last, afterwards, finally, later. So these are the words which describe the sequence. So we have to circle those and we have to arrange the sentence in sequences. So which sentence comes first, which sentence comes second, that is the sequence here. Now see here, yes, here I'm going to read there. After a few minutes, She turned the hot potato wedges over. Later, they both ate the potato wedges with buns. Jenny decided to help her father roast potato wedges on the campfire. Next, she held the stick so the potato wedges were just above the fire. First, she put the potato wedges on a long stick. Can you see there? First, she put potato wedges on a long stick. Finally, she removed the potato wedges from the fire and placed them in a plate. So, now this is the order. This is the jumbled sentences here. We have to arrange in a sequence. So, what was the first thing they have decided? What was the first thing here? Jenny, she wanted to, Jenny wanted to have a potato wedges. So, what she has done, how she has prepared potato wedges and how she had with her friend. Understood? So, let us see here. Now, you can see here, Jenny decided to help her father roast potato wedges on the campfire. So, this is the first sentence, right or no? First, what she decided? She decided to help her father to roast potato wedges on the campfire. So, this is the first. So, in the sequence column, you have to write, this is the first one here. This is the first one. After what she decided to help her father? Next, she held the stick on the potato wedges were just above the fire. No, this is not the correct answer. First, she put potato wedges on the long stick. When she decided her father to roast potato wedges on the campfire, what she did here? Next, what was the step here? First, she put potato wedges on a long stick. So, what was that? First, she put potato wedges on the long stick. So, this is the second sentence. After she decided to make potato wedges, what she does? She decided to put a long wedges on a long stick. So, this first is a word here. This first is what it is describing the sequence here. You have to circle that. Understood? Afterwards, what happens next? What is the next thing she decided? Yes. Next, she held the stick so the potato wedges were just above the fire. So, what is the next here? Next, she held the stick so the potato wedges were just on the fire. After that, next procedure, what was that? The D1. This is the third procedure. So, this is the third sequence. So, you have to circle the word here. You have to circle the word here. Next. Understood? So, this is the third sequence here. You have to do the third sequence there. And you have to circle the word here. Next. Understood there? Next one. What is the next one here? You can see here. Next one. After a few minutes, she turned the hot potato wedges over. After a few minutes, what happened? After a few minutes, she turned the potato wedges is over. After the next procedure, what she thought? The potato wedges is over. So, this is the fourth sequence. What you are going to write here? This is the fourth sequence. And what is the word here which is describing? After. Okay. Next one. Which is the next sequence you can decide here? Finally, she removed the potato wedges from the fire and placed them in a plate. So, what happened here? Finally, she removed after everything of potato wedges over. Now, so what she does that? She removed the potato wedges from the fire and placed them in a plate. So, this is the fifth sequence. What you are going to write? This is the fifth sequence. And you are going to circle which word here? Finally. What happened lastly? Later, they both ate the potato wedges with buns. Finally, when they prepared, they had the wedges with the buns. So, this is the sixth one. This is the sixth one. So what you are going to circle here, you are going to circle the later. Understood? How we have arranged the sequence here. Did you come to know how we have arranged the sequence here? Which sentence comes first, which is the second sentence, which is the third sentence. So sequence is nothing but arranging in a order way, which is first, which is second, which is later, which is last, and all those things. Understood? So this is a sequence here. Now see the next question there. Number the following sentences to show how dead wood is taken from the forest to the buyer. So read the sentences here. Now arrange the sequences. You have to arrange the sequences 1, 2, 3, 4. Which is the first sentences? Here what is that they have given you? How dead wood is taken from the forest. How dead wood is taken from the forest. Understood? To the buyer. So you have to see which sequence is going to come first. So this is homework, children. This is homework. So find out, see here what they have given you. Then their dry branches and are cut off. First dead trees are cut down. They are now logs. The logs are cut up into the large pieces of wood called lumber for building houses. Next, the logs are taken in the truck in a nearby sawmill. These are placed in a lumber yards where people can buy them. So see the sequence. What is the first, second, and write the number here. Understood? So this is homework for you. Understood, children? So that's all for this chapter. The chapter here, what is the name of the chapter? Time. So you have understood about the time, what is half past, what is quarter past, quarter to, what is long hand, short hand. We have also decided about the calendar, date, day, and the last one was sequences. Understood, children? So there is one activity, children. I'm going to give you one activity. You have to make a clock. See here in the next page, you can see in the next page there, they have given you here how to make a clock. They have also given you the procedure. So the activity I'm going to give you, you have to make a clock. That will be a activity for you people. This is also homework. I'll be giving you an activity. You have to make a clock there. Understood? Okay, children. In the next class, we'll discuss about the next chapter. Okay? Thank you, children.